call me a meat puppet? That's a new one. Oh, I can't affect this. Alright. Got four. No, five. Oh, I can't glitch him now. Insufficient RAM. Is that a door I have to open as well? Or do I just start shooting him? Wait a second. Oh, it says close. So the door is open. And the game begins. I think that's the guy. Is that him? Racketeer, it says. It looks like he's wearing an expensive suit. Where'd all the other guys go? They're all... Yeah, the bullets are flying away from them, right? Is that him? It's just a racket here. That's a little more effective. Turn it off. Alright, I got rid of that. He's over there. There's another back there. Your head was sticking up. They're all dead, that's what's with them. So this must be Jotaro himself, the only one left.
Where you got to, coward?
Am I right? Where is he? Oh, he's over. Wait a second. That's him, right? I want to scan him. So there's two? Oh.
To battle!
To battle, I like that. Who left combat? That's him, Jotaro Shoba, defiling human remains, human trafficking, and hostage taking. For that, I glitch you. And kill you. You can't shoot me, can you? Oh. Old Emerald Speed Muscle Tank. Are you still in combat? Hold on 1 second, guys. Okay, sorry about that. Take Jotaro's body and leave the area. Oh, okay. I still got people to kill. I hear them screaming their heads off. Well, before I leave the area, I want to get everything. Like an epic item or something there. Authorization not found. I thought that was a heart. New release, Braindances. Oh god. Like his torture thing. He was into like torturing people. I wish I could kill the person and stop the combat music, but I think they ran downstairs. So I'm gonna end up going downstairs to go get him. I don't want to run into them while I'm carrying this guy's body. That bothers me. I can't get in there. Oh, damn. Alright. I think I've gotten everything that can be gotten. Can't jack into these computers. Dr. Havoc and Radon. Volume 1. Let's go downstairs and see if we can take care of this screaming guy. Which way is downstairs again? Closer. Where the hell are you? It's not the bartender, is it? Do I have to kill the bartender? Oh! You're annoying. Please die. Any more? Yes? God. I figure pick up all the stuff first, then break it down. Alright. I was a little nutsy with those people down there. Did they run down there? Or they run in and join the battle after I ran upstairs. I gotta break some stuff down. All the chow guns. And Unity pistols. Really, just pistols mostly I have. Oh wait. This is the Dying Knight. Yeah, I don't want to keep that. I should put that in my apartment. Okay, now we'll go grab the body.
Top-end braindance equipment and the best chefs in the universe. If you're looking for a taste of...
How do you really know that? Have you explored the entire universe? Wait. Wait, how do I get upstairs again? This place is pretty big. I don't think it's... Oh, I just got an athletics thing? Automatically? It told me to open perks. Yeah, I do not know where I'm going. Going in the bathroom? Okay. I can't get, like, a local map? Okay, the game decided to crash. I think we missed a computer though? Yeah. And there was a camera up there that I turned off. No messages. Oh wait. They're all red, I guess. Studio equipment delivery. From Fan Yi to Jotaro Shoba. 1. Standard handcuffs. 2. Hand and ankle cuff set. 3. Small cage with strategically placed openings. Winky smiley face. Breathing tube, scalpel set, fecal collection system, ew. Epidural kit, dildo variety pack, rope, strap-on variety pack, anal beads and plugs, electrodes with cables, quad electrodes, aquarium, full suite, ambulance. All items should deliver within 5 business days. Expectations. From Jotaro to Lenny Nero. What should I scroll next? Binding and mutilation? Coercion? Distress? Torture? It's all become too... ordinary, no longer fresh. Perhaps I'll layer it with a feeling of impending death? Crescendo it throughout. It's a relatively simple approach for a stronger, tastier feel. I have many other ideas too, but my product also depends on your demand. My question is, what do you need? People are sick. From Lenny to Jotaro. Listen, all you gotta do is scroll, and whatever comes out of it, I can sell. No need to scrape the bottom of the barrel just yet. Sales are good. Let's leave a little room for imagination, for the unexpected. Your clientele's a unique bunch that knows more or less what to expect from you. Why hand over everything you got out of the gates? We sell the mystery, intrigue. People eat that stuff up. If they're willing to buy something off the beaten path, not knowing what to expect... This just amps the thrill, a feeling they associate with your work. They'll be hungry for more, and we can use that. Trust me, don't overthink this. You know what they want, and I know how to sell it. All cameras off, from Jotaro to Takeshi Taguchi. Cease all forms of data logging on my floor, cams, everything, and set up dampers. It better be impossible for anyone outside to hear me, but do it so it won't interfere with my BD equipment. I need this done now. International cuisine. From Jay Hyun to Jotaro. Good morning. I'm offering a new dish that should satisfy your sophisticated palate. Ingredients include 1 black lamb, 2 pink porky boys, and with an Asian twist, a young hen and a rooster. In total, 5 young up-and-coming stars who are dying to perform in your productions. Okay, so they're calling them lambs, but they're people, right? Important, make sure to apply the cream provided in your package to their biomonitor wounds. It'd be a shame if they died in the middle of scrolling because of some silly infection. Oh my god. Also, I equipped each with a GPS in case any of them try to go out for any long walks. This is horrible. But most importantly, have some fun. As of today, they're your property. Oh, I'm glad I killed this guy. P.S. I want to kill this Jay Hyun as well. I know you don't like surprises, so I personally double-checked their histories. None have ever screwed professionally, so it's up to you to convince them and break them in how you see fit. This is making me sick. I only hope this time they prove more durable, Jotaro says. I can't cook with soft ingredients. Whatever. Raw files for edits. Last month's BD scrolls were all ready for editing. Is this Shobo? Notes, ideas? Or Jotaro Shobo? Notes, ideas, inspirations? Expanding the brain dance art form, thoughts and ideas, like in that film, Days of Uninterrupted Sodomy Domination, Playing with Crap, Play How, Need Novel Ideas, groups of boys and girls, bind two people facing each other but loose enough to move a little, forced to do things to each other they don't like. Ugh. Need to interrogate first to find out, such as screwing someone ugly, homeless, at the same time something to catch at least 5 seconds of pleasure mixed with either guilt or disgust. This is horrible. Link optics of two people to scroll BD of one through experience of the other. Mixed feelings of recorded body and linked observer. Force the recording body to screw a person the observer cares about deeply. Requires a lot of setup and coordination. Too much? I'm glad he's dead. Oh, is that me? That's me. I'm like, who's hiding back there? That's me again. So there's just two. Because I turned the other one off. Yeah, I'm not even looking in the corner. Alright, so. So I want to turn them all off, actually. Are they all off? I messed myself up there by turning it on. I turned it back off, though. That might be a mistake, but I don't know if anyone else is in here to be alerted. Describe conversation. Yeah, I'm gonna read that. Jotaro says, come over. I have a few bodies to get rid of. Elazar Flores says, in cold storage? Why? Yes. Okay, I'll come tomorrow. They'll be cremating a few at La Katrina, so I'll toss in yours. Jotaro says, just come and take them. I don't care about the rest. Understood. Saving and picking up body. Wrong key. Wait, did I ever go in here? I killed him. Yeah, I was in here. Okay. Not to worry about keeping him alive. Obviously. He's dead. Stairs down this way, I think. Take his body and leave the area. Take it where? Just outside? Nothing to see here, just someone carrying a body around. Did I turn all that stuff off? There's another set of stairs. Just don't know where it is. go through this way. That's the stairs up. Here we go. Now the place is full of people.
Don't shoot!
I can't shoot you, I've got a body.
Please!
Please, brother. How do I get out of here?
Please! Have mercy on me! Your sexy ass somewhere else.
Your sexy ass somewhere else, really? Okay. I put his body down. Did I put it down? Drop. Leave the area. I guess I'm gonna leave the area even more. I keep pressing the wrong key. Whoops. Carry him to the fixers. Yeah. Don't look at that. That was freaky. There's something over here, though. That's how to get that vinyl record. Oh, to the fixers. Oh, right there. Hmm. Job complete. Monster hunt.
Jotaro received. The Mox will gladly take him off my hands. Give him a taste of his own meds. Thanks, Gigshut.
Awesome. Yay. New gigs available. Hold on. Where are we? I know where we are, but where is stuff? Agent Seb 2? So, let's do this stuff next. Should I read through, see what new stuff we got?
Sure.
Actually. See if there's anything new. Okay, nothing new there. Braindance, available titles. Body Horror 12, the first and last time, Arachnophobia Unleashed, oh my god, My Big Fat Chrome Body, Welcome to Hell 2, Rotted Alive Golden Shot 2. That's it for that. The Green Death, Technology, alright. Guest Editorial, Braindance editors have long since strived to strike a balance between real lived experience and technological experiential purity. The more heavily processed the material, the more abstracted the pathways, the clearer the braindance recording. These fundamental elements of design have guided editors since the first wave of brain-to-brain experience sharing technology took hold. In the pursuit of balance, however, editors have clearly shown a bias for purity over naturalism over the years, even going so far as to use it as a point of pride in the quality of their production. But in the industry's latest push for greater purity, has the purpose of the technology already been forgotten? Will we not find ourselves processing and filtering a braindance recording to the point that the emotional experience no longer extends beyond what we receive from film, television, and video games. After reliving some of the latest titles on my feeder unit, this once academic question now feels all too inevitable with the industry's current trajectory. For a moment, let's consider why some reports suggest more and more users are searching for unlicensed titles on the black market, so-called black brain dances, extreme brain dances, or XBDs. Are we so sure it's the illicit content they're after? Or maybe the real draw is the residual grit re-editors try so hard to remove, distracting thoughts, irrelevant memories, loose associative threads, emotions stretching beyond the desired spectrum. What if this noise is not so superfluous as we believe it to be? What if these peripheral experiences hold the potential to elevate a good brain dance to an exquisite one? We do ourselves a... We do ourselves a disservice by not exploring these questions before our blind crusade for brain dance purity leads this industry straight into the bin of obsolete flash-in-the-pan technology. J.A. Relive it. The quarterly magazine for brain dance editors, amateurs, and enthusiasts, volume 478, December 2076. Okay. And then we've got The Green Death. The weathered man peered into the eyes of the young nomad as if trying to divine his thoughts. "Don't misunderstand," he said. "I don't mind unexpected guests, but you must recognize, when a man lives alone in the middle of the desert, he has a right to ask uncomfortable questions." The boy wouldn't make eye contact, instead glancing nervously through the window, as if expecting to spot an armada of battle drones coursing straight for him across the night sky. "I'm running away," he muttered after a moment of hesitation. "From Green Phantom. He's been following me since Yellow Creek." Some colors. The old man didn't move a muscle save for a twitch at the corner of his mouth, revealing he knew more than he cared to admit. "You have nothing to fear," he said softly. "The Green Phantom only comes for the worst criminals. If you hold regret in your heart, he'll forgive you. He'll offer a second chance." The boy's anxious demeanor suddenly turned to a rebellious grin. "I regret nothing. And you, old man, you don't have the faintest clue what you're prattling on about." "You're wrong. I've also met the Phantom once before." The tenderfoot nomad's eyes widened in surprise for a brief moment. It seemed as if there was a question at the tip of his lips, but he refused to ask it. "It's late," the old man said. "You should sleep. You're exhausted and need to gather your strength before you continue running, if that's what you choose to do. My home is open to you for the night." The boy uttered no thanks. Without a word, he stood and entered the small, dark bedroom where his host had prepared a bed. To find his way, he switched on his infrared, then immediately froze in place. There was a body lying in the bed. He edged closer until he could discern its shapes. A pool of cooling blood, withered hands, contorted into unnatural angles, the vacant, dead eyes of the old man he had only just been talking to in the other room. Suddenly the walls began to emanate an otherworldly olive glow. The boy could sense a figure enter the bedroom and stand behind him. "If you regret nothing," hissed a cold, emotionless voice, "then why do you flee?" Then black. The world of the young nomad plunged into darkness. That was cool. So he killed the old man. The Green Death did. Or the Green Phantom? Yeah, the Green Phantom killed the old man and took his appearance. That's pretty cool. I want to hear more about this Green Phantom. Anyway, stay tuned for next episode where we explore this stuff. Agent Saboteur, and there's an assault in progress here. And we might meet with Takamura after. There's a reported crime as well and an undiscovered thingy. I don't know. We might just do these things. We're not talking to the cops yet. We're not doing Ghost Town yet. Yeah, it looks like... we'll do eh, 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 and eh. And then then if nothing new pops up from doing that stuff, we'll meet with Takamura. How about that? Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.